and I call on Deputy Barry Cowan.
Thank you, Lex Concorda. Minister White, there's another report today from Simon saying that rents in Dublin are up 8.2% since last year. And Daft says nationally that rent for a two-bedroom house is 20% up, or 20% above the rent supplement. Families with children are being squeezed out of the rental market, yet you've refused to increase the rent supplement, even though you and your government and your tarnisher were asked to do so since 2012. Private supply of housing in Dublin in particular is stagnant. House repossession cases continue at pace, with 100 alone in Cork today. And there could be thousands more on the housing waiting list by the end of the year, according to Father Peter McVerry. This government, and let there be no doubt about it, unfortunately, have let this national crisis develop. They've reacted with too little and too late. And even though you've made many announcements, the actions after these are far and few between. There's chaos in the housing sector, and the numbers of homeless is mounting. There's no easing off at all. The government have failed to address this issue. And it's not just me or any other member of the opposition that are saying this. It's been said by Simon, by Focus Ireland, Vincent DePaul, Brother Kevin and Father McFerry. There are up to 3,000 vacant units across the country that need refurbishment before families could move in. Yet Minister Kelly and this government has cut £6 million from the refurbishment fund. It makes no sense whatsoever. It's a lesson, in fact, on how to make things worse. For the past 4.5 years, you've insisted that rent supplement will not be increased, as it will drive rents higher, you say. Why are you persisting with using the rent supplement to control the private sector rather than the poverty alleviating measure it is meant to be? And lastly, I want to ask this question that has been answered in many different forms in the last few weeks, so I'd like some clarity in relation to it. Minister Kelly and the Taoiseach have sought to answer it. And the Taoiseach said, I think last Tuesday week, that he had ordered that the government, on foot of a meeting, cabinet meeting that morning, had ordered 150 modular units for Dublin families. How much have they cost? When will they be delivered? Is emergency planning legislation required for them to be placed? And most importantly, when will families be moved into them?
Thank you. Minister.
Thank you, Lasc Count Corla. Well, first of all, it is not acceptable that in Ireland in 2015 that we have families living in emergency accommodation. It's not acceptable to the government, not acceptable to this Oireachtas, and not acceptable to the people. And that is a shared perspective that we have in relation to the fact that we have a serious problem here. Many of the problems stem from, as the Deputy well knows, from a chronic lack of supply of housing, which is causing knock-on problems across the property market and the wider society, from renters, first-time buyers and low-income households. What we have to do is, as the Deputy is calling for, is to take action to resolve it. And that's what this government is doing. And as the House will be aware, the government is progressing a number of suitable property and policy solutions for families who are in emergency accommodation. There's a range of measures already underway, taken by the Minister and by the Government. I'll just mention a few. For example, returning void units to full use. That's in train. The Minister has indicated to local authorities that additional funding will be made available, and indeed he has made additional funding available in circumstances where local authorities exceed their 2015 targets. The most recent projections that we have, Lasc Count Corla, indicate that over 2,500 voids will be returned nationally by year-end. I give that as an example. In terms of the scale of the homelessness problem, and we do have a problem, we accept that, 3,372 adult individuals used state-funded emergency accommodation nationally during a week in August 2015. Those figures identify 707 families in emergency accommodation, consisting of 959 adults and 1,496 dependents. We understand the problem is serious and we're addressing the problem. How are we addressing it? In 2015, there was an allocation in the Dublin region of €37.16 million, and that was confirmed for the Dublin region, representing more than 70% of all the funding allocated nationally. The Dublin Region Homeless Executive has confirmed that its expenditure to end August was €33.4 million. with further expenditure committed but not yet paid out. These are actions that are being taken. The Department of the Environment officials, Laskin Corla, in ongoing liaison with the Dublin Region Homeless Executive and Dublin City Council in relation to the possible 2015, further possible 2015 requirements. In relation to the modular housing that the Deputy raised, and I note that the proposal, and it is only one aspect of the resolution of this problem in relation to the modular housing element, that it has been well received by organisations and NGOs and other interested and active individuals in this sector and have welcomed it. It was approved, the government has approved the immediate initiation of a programme for the early delivery of 500 units of modular housing. They'll be delivered in two tranches of 150 and 350. The first 150 units are planned to be delivered within 4 months, I can tell the Deputy, on sites in the Dublin City Council area, utilising the most expeditious procurement and planning provisions that are available to us. A parallel process to develop a national framework will be overseen by the Office of Government Procurement to address the issues raised by the Deputy, and this framework will be used to deliver the 350 units, the additional 350 units that I mentioned, and will also be available to any local authority to procure further modular housing. There are many other policy instruments that are being adopted and pursued by the Minister and by the Government in relation to tenancy protection, in relation to the allocation of local authority tenancies. We have a task force on social housing and homelessness. This is an extremely challenging issue and problem for the government, and nobody is making light of that for one moment. But it has to be addressed through practical measures, through systematic measures taken by the government, by the minister, Minister Kelly in particular, to ensure that we address this difficult and challenging problem. And the government is doing that, and we will deliver the answers that are required in terms of bringing these issues to a conclusion.
Supplementary question from Deputy Barry Cowan. Order, please.
Thank you, Kieran Corrigan. You're a great man to commentate, like some of your colleagues beside you.
Where's Angry Ellen?
You know, it's very similar to a lot of your announcements and press releases and talk of it being a number one priority. But there's no action to follow up any of this. And I asked you, notwithstanding, excuse me, if you don't mind. You've had 4.5 years to address this issue. You haven't addressed it to date.
Please.
I've no doubt.
Deputy Cowan, please.
Excuse me. Between 2007 and 2010, there were 14,500 units built by local authorities on foot of government policy. In the first 3 years of this government, you built 107. Right? 107. There are 10 local authorities that have built none. That's your legacy. So can I leave that with you? Can you mull over that for a minute, if you don't mind? Mull over that. Now, can I, if I might be allowed to ask a supplementary question, subject to the commentary of an answer I got from the gentleman across.
Okay. Now, can we have order, please? Deputy Cowan has the floor. Deputies. Look at members. Deputy Cowan has the floor. It's leader's questions. Leader's questions, please. Deputy Cowan.
To get to the nub of the question, I specifically asked you because there's an immediacy and urgency required to deal with the terrible situation that exists on the streets of Dublin and many other parts of the country. And you heard this morning people talking about living in tents. You heard a woman on the radio some weeks ago living in a hotel. Like 1,500 families are in emergency accommodation. So there's an immediacy and an urgency required to address this issue. And some a couple of weeks ago, when I said to Taoiseach and the Minister for the Environment, Minister Kelly, said the 150 units that had been ordered would be in place before Christmas. You now tell me it'll be up to 4 months. We're going on to February now at this stage. Can I ask you, are you sure even at that where these will be located and planning permission will have been secured for those units to be in place within 4 months? Because it's highly unlikely, knowing how the procurement and planning process works and the length of time it takes, and you should know that as well as I.
Thank you.
That being the case, is it not that you can at this stage at least, further to what the Minister said on TV last Sunday and further to what he has said and the Taoiseach has said in this House previously, will you bring forward emergency legislation to allow for permission to be more forthcoming than the normal procurement process for which it takes?
Thank you.
That's the sort of immediacy and urgency and emergency issues that need to be brought to the House to address this issue in real terms. In real terms. There are 130,000 on the waiting list. There was 90,000 when you came into office. There are 2,600 homes around the country empty. You have cut the refurbishment amount by 6 million year on year. They're the facts. Now deal with the urgency and the immediacy of the situation if you want some legacy in this area before you go to the country.
Thank you. Minister, Minister has the floor, please.
The deputy accuses me.
Minister. Could we have order, please? The Minister's reply.
The deputy accuses me of engaging in commentary. That's quite strange coming from him. And he says there's no action. An additional 2.2 billion euro in funding announced in Budget 2015 in relation to social housing strategy. The strategy is a comprehensive response, I think the House, reasonable people will accept, to the need for social housing. We need to build houses. We have a problem, we need to build houses. And even the deputies opposite must understand that it takes time to put together a process by which you will actually build houses. We have a target of 110,000 social housing units to 2020. 35,000 new social housing units and 75,000 through the housing assistance payment. That is not commentary. That is a target. Now, if the members opposite have practical proposals to make, practical suggestions, I'll come to the one the deputy made a minute ago, we would be delighted to hear them. But sometimes you have the impression that these issues, these really difficult, very, very serious social issues are, there's a danger always that they are, as it were, leveraged in order to make a political point in here rather than actually trying to address a real social pressing problem and try to resolve it. There's always a danger. Now, if it's necessary to introduce legislation to address the procurement question, I'm sure the minister will do that. It may not be necessary. It may not be necessary to have legislation in order to address the issue of procurement. It may well be possible to deliver these modular homes without having to change the legislation. And why would we want? Well, the deputy just wants to throw it around. Let's have emergency legislation so that he can utter the word emergency as often as he possibly can in the course of his question. But what we're doing is we're actually addressing the problem. We are delivering solutions, and the deputies opposite have no solutions and no proposals other than attack.
Thank you. Deputy Eagles O'Snoddy. Could we have order, please? Deputy O'Snoddy.
Cormorgan,